Oh, friends, it is a beautiful day outside and I am I'm positively joyful today. So I thought I would take you through some of my daily routines and what I'm doing each day to help reset this sustainable lifestyle that I've been trying to do, reset my zero waste lifestyle. I guess you call this episode 2, where we're kind of looking at my daily routines and seeing how we can make them more sustainable, understand how to try and implement new kind of habits or just refresh and look at different ways of understanding what sustainability really means to me and to other people, and to just try and live that sustainable lifestyle. So for example, for Earth Month, I am collaborating with a creator on Instagram called Tiffany. I think that she is just an incredible creator, and she also just emanates what true sustainability is in your everyday life. So we're going to be doing a reel every Thursday for Earth Month. So be sure to check those out on Instagram. I'll leave her link and my link down below. So if you want to help this girl get to 100k, try to get there, so go and follow me on Instagram. Thanks very much, I appreciate it. So I'm going to show you how things are doing. My seedlings are finally coming up, which is possibly the most exciting thing that has happened to me in the last year. Not really, but certainly this year. We're already getting into April this week, which I really can't believe. In fact, today is April 1st, which is pretty amazing because, well, not today that I'm filming this, that this video goes up, because it's Earth Month, and it just gives you this kind of reinvigoration, this re-motivation to look at what we're doing and live that sustainable lifestyle, as I said. As you can hear, probably the neighbors are all out mowing the lawns because it is time. And the great thing about mowing your lawn is that grass can be used as mulch. It contains a lot of water, which is really great. And I think nitrogen, perhaps. I've been learning about gardening, guys. Been learning. Because I've been also trying to learn about how to create your own compost, but that's going to be something for future when I actually have a garden of my own. But I've been talking to my parents about this no-dig method as well as creating your own compost. They did it before, but then I think a wasp's nest made their way in there and then they couldn't go near it anymore. And then I think they also got rats because they started putting food in it, so they're moving to a sort of organic matter garden only compost, I think. But I'm just really excited to share my day with you, trying to live that sustainable lifestyle, what I'm gonna eat today, planting, all of these things, and some daily routines. So hopefully you'll enjoy this video. If you do, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe so that you never miss another video in this series. And again, thank you so much for all of your beautiful, wonderful, encouraging comments on my previous few videos. It really meant a lot. Might even go to the garden center again today. That's probably the most exciting thing I've been able to do during lockdown, because it's like one of the only essential shops that's open. I've got my basket here, which I'm very excited about. I might get a nasturtium plant because you can eat every part of the nasturtium. So I just want to say thank you to everyone who recommended people and told me about the no-dig method. I've been looking into that and talking to my mum about it, and we're going to be using that going forward, which is really cool. Making our own compost. It's just so exciting. I haven't been this excited about anything in such a long time. And I'm glad that you guys are here for the journey. So let's have our cup of coffee, as per usual. And let's get going. Thank you. So the reason why I decided to plant more seeds, I planted quite a few rocket seeds yesterday, is because, well, one, we're having some form of heat wave this week. It's really sunny. So I wanted to take advantage of the heat that's going to be in the conservatory, because it's way hotter in the conservatory than it is outside. And I just wanted to take advantage of that to try and sprout some more seeds and just kind of be a bit experimental. We have quite a few seeds from last year, so it's not like I'm losing out on anything. And I think when it comes to gardening, it's really important to experiment with, you know, what works for you, what works for your soil, all of these different things. And also, this is just meant to be something really fun and, you know, that hopefully has this incredible outcome. It just gives me a way to also experiment with different ways of seeding to see which one that I'm best at, but also that works well for my seeds and things like that. But I'm not going to plant too much because, as I said before, I want to start with a small garden and to really try and make sure I'm doing the best that I possibly can. So I've been watching so many videos, as I said before, reading lots of books, talking to my mum, and our neighbour actually used to be an agricultural economist, and his greenhouse is incredible. He's had his vaccines now because he's in his 80s, so we might go round just into his garden later and have a look at the way he's trellised his tomato plants, because he is an expert. So I would love to see what he's done. And my mum always says that his are amazing. Last year when I went round to look at his raised beds, I mean, it's pretty incredible what he's been able to do. So yeah, the tomato plants, we've got two. One that's kind of like going to be a bushy type one, so that's going to stay small and compact. But the other one, I think it's a condor is what they're called, or cordon, sorry, and that's gonna grow. So I need to trellis both of them anyway to give them support for when the fruit grows so it doesn't get too heavy. Yeah, show you his greenhouse, what he's got. And he also has a pheasant called Bert that has just made his garden his home and just hangs out with him. So hopefully we'll catch him as well, and I can show you, because pheasants are really beautiful. Okay, so I'm gonna go to my local zero waste shop. I wanna support them and I need to get some stuff. So I'm gonna take my basket with me. I love this basket, nice and rigid, so it protects my vegetables. Gonna get some vegetables, some dry ingredients, and more seeds, I think, for sprouting. What else? Also, I found this cardigan in my attic, which I bought in literally 2012, maybe. So tell me if we hate it. My mum absolutely hates it, but I don't have any cardigans apart from my granny's cardigan. So I have been enjoying using it rather than a jacket as it gets warmer, but let me know if we hate it. Okay, because we are decluttering clothes. And it's perfectly good, like it can be sold, you know, by a charity shop. But yeah, let me know if we hate it. My mum hates it. I don't know. My sister hates it as well. Leave it. Did you stop? Okay, people are in the kitchen being very loud, so I'm gonna show you what I got from the zero waste shop today. It's quite expensive. I was like £23 for all of this stuff, which it's quite a lot. I also went to the bakery because I absolutely love this bakery in this little town called Lewis called Flint Owl, and I got some rye bread. My rye bread is still not quite up to scratch, so I thought I'd just go for one that I know is good, support my local bakery. And then from the zero waste shop, I got a cucumber, I got some more seeds. I get my seeds from there because, well, I want to support them, but also they come just in paper, so you can completely either compost this or recycle it, which is great. Yep, so I got those. I got just broccoli sprouts and radish sprouts this time. I didn't get any mung beans. And then I got two small cauliflowers. Unfortunately, I didn't have enough bags. I wasn't sure if I was going to be allowed to use my bags because of COVID, but they did. But I didn't bring enough, so I've got peanuts in here to make peanut butter. Now, this was the most expensive item for about a 0.7 kilograms, so 700 grams. This was about £6 for roasted peanuts, so that was more expensive than I thought it was going to be. And then I got four sweet potatoes. I really like my sweet potatoes like this, that are long and slim and obviously weird looking or whatever, because I find them, I just prefer, they cook a lot quicker, and also, yeah, they're just easier in terms of how I do my food. And then I got some whole grain or wholemeal pasta, and I really love this one. This cost me about £1.70, which is probably more expensive than in a normal shop. Probably, I wouldn't say double the price, but I'd say about 70p more. So that's probably about 2/3 more. So yeah, expensive. And then the last thing, it is in plastic, but I wanted to get some tempeh that is locally produced, soil association, organic, all that kind of stuff. And just try it out to see what it's like, because if it's nice, then I'm gonna try and definitely marinate mine and stuff like that. So yeah, I'm gonna have this for lunch, I think, with probably some more pasta and pesto, to be honest. I just kind of like eating the same things. And I might even make a cucumber kimchi later using Remy from Veggiekins. She's done a recipe, so I might try that. Or the Korean vegan. She's done really, really good recipe on it as well, which I'll leave the links to both of them down below. I'm gonna go make some peanut butter now with these. If you wanna know, I've got a whole video on how to make peanut butter. It's literally so easy. And I also have some hazelnuts left over from my food prep last week, so I might make some hazelnut, coconut, and cocoa kind of mix. Kind of like a vegan Nutella, I guess, but like a nut butter. So I'm gonna go and make those now. I don't know if I'm gonna have time to add this to this video. So if I don't, thank you for watching this video. I hope that you enjoyed it. Just simple daily routines, you know, of my life in spring. And yeah, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe so you never miss another video. And if you want to support me, go over to Instagram and follow me there, because we are on a mission to get to 100k, and then we can just chill. Thank you. See you guys later.